there is a human need that only a few can satisfy. Yuri Orlov satisfied that need. It was the need for arms. He is the Lord of War, the notorious arms dealer. He built a business chain with the leaders of the world and had a woman of his dreams. But can he keep all these with the Interpol following his every move? We'll find out. Before we continue, do not forget to quickly subscribe to the channel. It will encourage the team. And thank you to all our subscribers so far. Now, let's begin. The movie begins as we see Yuri Orlov surrounded by empty bullet shells as he narrates the story of his life as an arms dealer. He claims that there are more than 500 million guns in the world, one for every 12 people. He says the question is, how do we arm the remaining 11? The movie then goes back to 1982 and shows how he became what he is. The title sequence follows the journey of a bullet being produced and going through various stages in the factory, including different inspections and then transportation to the end users who, in this case, are some Africans involved in a war. The bullet gets selected and it is fired from an AK-47 and travels through the head of a child soldier during a war in Africa. Yuri tells us how he and his family fled from Ukraine to the US, pretending to be Jewish refugees. His family runs a restaurant, but Yuri is not satisfied with feeding people. He sees an opportunity to make money by supplying another human need, guns. He gets inspired by a Ukrainian mobster who kills two hitmen in his restaurant. Yuri also tells us that he has a long-standing crush on Eva Fontaine, a famous model. Yuri starts his business by buying Uzis, a semi-automatic pistol, from a contact he met at a synagogue and selling them to local gangs. He convinces his brother Vitaly to join him as his partner. They ended up going to Berlin to attend a weapons fair, where Yuri tried to pitch his idea to Simeon Wise, an experienced arms dealer. Wise was not buying the idea and he rejected him, calling him a novice. Yuri's first big opportunity to sell M16s came after the 1982 Lebanon War, where he became what he calls a dealer of death who did not discriminate, supplying weapons to all parties involved. He even delivered arms to Afghanistan when they were fighting against his own countrymen, the Soviets. He took advantage of the fact that the Americans often left behind their used guns when they withdrew from a conflict, and he made a profit from them. Yuri created multiple identities with matching documents and IDs, and kept his records and paperwork in a metal safe. He further tells us of how he first met Jack Valentine, an Interpol agent who was incorruptible. They crossed paths when Yuri was on the Crystal ship, smuggling a shipment of arms. He got a tip off that Valentine was on his trail and he had to act fast. He ordered his men to change the name of the ship to Kono, and he managed to fool Valentine when he boarded the ship. Yuri's business took him to Colombia, where he had to deal with a drug lord who paid him in cocaine instead of money. He protested, but he had no choice but to accept the payment after being shot. He and Vitaly snorted some of the cocaine, but Vitaly became addicted and fled to Bolivia. Yuri tracked him down and convinced him to go to a rehab center. After that, Yuri continued his arms trade alone. He turned his attention towards pursuing his obsession with Eva Fontaine, a woman he wanted to have at any cost. He arranged a photo shoot and booked the entire hotel so that he could have her alone. He pretended that he was unaware of what was going on, and when Eva approached him, Yuri offered her a ride on his private jet back to New York, since there were no other flights available for the next few days. He took Eva back to New York on his private jet, which he had rented and had his name on it. This impressed Eva and was easily charmed by Yuri on their flight back. They got married with an elaborate celebration. They welcomed a son whom Yuri named Nicolai. On the day that Nicolai took his first steps, the Soviet Union collapsed and Yuri was overjoyed. He envisioned the possibilities that the end of the war would bring him. Yuri hurries to Ukraine after seeing Gorbachev's farewell speech on TV on Christmas Day 1991. He gets in touch with his uncle, Dmitry, a former Soviet army general, and starts buying his tanks and AK-47s to increase his stock, describing in detail how the AK-47 is the most dependable assault rifle in the world. Wise returns and tries to negotiate with both Yuri and Dmitry, but they both turn him down. Valentine tries to stop Yuri again as he attempts to ship off a Mil-Mi-24. Luckily, a young Soviet army mechanic had disassembled the weapons, and because of a legal loophole that does not consider either of them as weapons of war as long as they are shipped separately, Valentine had to let him go for now. He wanted solid evidence against Yuri and didn't want to break the law himself. Soon after, Wise plants a car bomb, and Dmitry is killed. This ended Yuri's deal and he had to look for other alternatives. Yuri extended his network to Africa and started selling arms to the Liberian dictator, André Baptiste, who pays in blood diamonds. When they first met, André Baptiste shot one of his men who was hitting on a girl in his presence. Yuri was initially shocked and a little scared, but he regained his composure and they eventually made a deal. While in Liberia, André took Yuri to his children's soldiers' parade, and while Yuri questioned why he used children, Andre tells him that a gun is as powerful in the hand of a 12-year-old as it is in the hand of a 45-year-old. He then told Yuri that he prefers to call him Lord of War, and insisted on it even when Yuri said it should be Warlord. When Yuri arrived home, he met Ava and his brother who had come with his latest girlfriend. Vitaly was living a very confused life, and Yuri asked him to get his act straight. After digging through Yuri's garbage, Valentine learns that Yuri will be making a cargo run to Sierra Leone. Valentine had fighter planes successfully intercept the plane in flight, and threatened to shoot the plane down if the pilot did not comply with their order of landing at the airport. Yuri, however, told the pilot to make an emergency landing on a dirt road. When the pilot says that it is impossible, Yuri encourages him, calling him the best pilot. Pilot eventually gathered courage and successfully landed in a village. Valentine decided to land at the airport and rode to where Yuri had landed. After making the landing, the pilots abandoned Yuri, saying that they needed to get away from the evidence as far as possible. Yuri tells them that there would be no evidence and successfully gives away all the guns to local villagers before Valentine can arrive and detain him. Valentine handcuffs and keeps Yuri for 24 hours before being forced to release him. Yuri then makes his way back to Monrovia, where Andre invites him to kill the captured Wise, who simply states he came to Liberia to sell weapons to Baptiste's enemies. Yuri is reluctant, but does not tell Baptiste to stop pulling the trigger until he has done so and killed Wise. Yuri was frustrated with his life and got drunk that night. Wise later appears in a drug-induced hallucination and continues to tell Yuri to take sides in his arms business. Valentine keeps Yuri under surveillance, and one day he was forced to reveal to his wife, Ava, that Yuri is a major weapons dealer. Ava pleads with Yuri to stop, and he does for a while and chooses to exploit the resources of the Third World nations. However, he dislikes the business, complaining that the profit margins are low and that there is too much competition compared to illegal arms. Yuri re-enters the arms market when Baptiste approaches him. He is reluctant, but goes when Baptiste tells him that he will pay more than the usual rate. Yuri decides to bring Vitaly along because he is nervous about the current climate of Liberia. However, they later learn that the sale is actually taking place in Sierra Leone. As the deal is happening, Vitaly sees a mob of locals killing a woman and her kid, and begs Yuri to cancel the sale, saying that everyone in the village will die if they go ahead. Yuri says it's not their problem and asked Vitaly to ignore whatever was happening around them and focus on the business. Vitaly knew it was hopeless trying to convince his brother, so he acted. He grabbed a grenade, throwing it into a truck with half of the weapons, and ran towards the second truck to do the same, but a guard who was watching the deal shoots Vitaly. He died in Yuri's arms. Devastated, Yuri still completes the sale and all the villagers are then massacred. Yuri takes his brother's body back to the US with him. He pays someone $20 to extract the bullets from Vitaly's body, but one bullet was found on his body when they got to America and he is arrested at the airport. At the same time, Ava discovers Yuri's security container, which is undeniable evidence of Yuri's continuous arms dealing. She was heartbroken that Yuri was still involved with arms after everything. Ava then takes their son and leaves the house. While being detained, Yuri calls his parents, but his mother tells him, "Both my sons are dead." Yuri was transferred into Valentine's custody and Valentine tells him that he faces a long prison term. However, Yuri tells Valentine that the same reasons that should put him behind bars are also the ones that will set him free. His existence is a necessary evil, as he often supplies the enemies of your enemies, in this case, the enemies of the US. He adds that sometimes the US government needs a freelancer like him to supply those that they don't want to be seen supplying. Yuri predicts that a senior officer will arrive, praise Valentine for apprehending Yuri, and then instruct him to release Yuri because of his indispensability. His foresight is accurate, and a senior officer does show up, and Yuri is freed. Once again, he resumes his arms trade. The movie returns to the initial scene, and Yuri declares that he knows that arms traders are the ones that will inherit the earth because everyone else is too preoccupied with killing each other. He also advised to never go to war, especially with yourself. I really hope you enjoyed this movie. You can check out these new recaps on the page and do not forget to subscribe to the channel for more videos. Also, you can drop a like and comment on the video. We'll love to hear from you. Until our next recap, stay safe.